Good afternoon, everybody. The discussion topic is rooftop and distributed solar in Maharashtra. First, we'll start with our introduction. Myself, Nandita Jain, I'm representing Jinsol Engineering here. We are consultancy into solar businesses, rooftop models, EPCs, O&M, and we have a new arm of electric vehicles in the name of Blue Smart. We are operational in Delhi, Mumbai, and our head office is in Ahmedabad. We have come out with a new vertical of EHV businesses also. We supply manpower there. And now I'll roll on the mic to the...
Hi everyone, I'm Sachin Agrawal. I'm DGM and looking after the renewable portfolio of Godrej and Boyce company. We have our vision of having 30% of our power from renewable source of energy. It can be on-site, it can be off-site, it can be from solar, it can be from wind, it can be from fuel cells. So we are working on various different technologies and how we can integrate various sources of energy into our consumption. And I am pleased to announce that as a Godrej and Boyce, we have first net zero building which has been certified in Asia, and it is carbon neutral, it is water neutral. So we are not working only on the carbon, but we are also working on water. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Sushant. I'm looking after the Western region for Amplus. Amplus is one of the leading developer in C&I sector, in rooftop as well as in open access. We have more than 700 megawatt of portfolio in India, and we are part of a Petronas group. Thank you everyone.
Good afternoon all, this is Rahul Nalawade. I am heading renewable energy business, mainly wind, solar, both rooftop as well as utility scale. And with the motto of passion for sustainability, we have so far achieved close to 200 megawatts into wind as well as solar, and moving towards more and more clean and green energy. Thank you to EQ team. I think this is a really great platform with all the dignitaries over here. And definitely this will be a knowledge sharing session amongst all. And let's hope for the best.
Good afternoon. Myself Sachin Talewar, Chief Engineer, Maharashtra State Electricity Distribution Utility at Pune. We are one of the largest distribution utility of India, and similarly, Pune is the revenue capital of our MSEDCL. We are contributing around 20% of the revenue of MSEDCL, of total Maharashtra, around 14,000 crore per annum revenue we are generating from Pune. Yes. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. I am Sudhanshu Kamboj. I am heading the BD in Hinduja Renewables. So Hinduja Renewables is a IPP, which is in large-scale utility scale plants as well as in the rooftop segment. We are aspiring to grow our portfolio to gigawatt level. We have vision of being there in this sustainable business for long years. We are also tracking new technologies like EV vehicle, charging infrastructure, storage technology, hydrogen economy, offshore wind. We are also trying to acquire companies which are available in solar as well as wind. So we are open to expansion both through greenfield as well through brownfield. It will be an interesting session today to speak to you, take your questions, give our views, and understand how we want this industry to progress in our country. We have people from government side, from the DISCOM side. So we would like to know their views, how they feel about the private entities expanding their footprint into solar, and how we can work together to make sure that we coexist as well as we bring green power to the country and save the nation. Because security of energy is one of the major concern, which maybe in another 10, 20 years, most of the transportation as well as other, even the industry will be running on electricity. So electric security or the power security will be a major concern for most of the countries. and this is a good time for the industry to grow. So we want to explore how we can work together with the government and grow together. Thanks.
Hello. Yeah. Good afternoon, everybody. I am Krishnendu Mukherjee. I'm representing Sova Solar Limited. We are based out of Kolkata and we are a module manufacturing company having presence across India, and we have been in this business for the last 12 years. And I thank EQ for inviting us to this panel discussion, and I hope that we can exchange our views, learn from each other, and develop this industry as a whole. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Suvendu Lenka. I am from Thermax Solar Division. Thermax as a company, we have completely, almost till now, we have completed 55 megawatt of solar rooftop project. We are a company which is highly focused on rooftop solar segment. Of course, isolatedly, we keep doing some of, more or less, we are more into a rooftop, very, the engineering capability of Thermax, which is also like part of our power division, like in which we have done 2,800 megawatt plus of conventional power projects. So I think same kind of credibility we carry to our rooftop segment. And it's been, when we talk of the rooftop segment, it's a very exciting field overall. Of course, I can see I think the presenter was trying to cheer up everyone in between to talk something more and to have that happiness feeling. Of course, I know that everyone mind there is a concern on how do I increase my revenue at the same time I keep my bottom line. I think more or less, no one has said that, but I think starting from the DISCOM, starting from all the EPC and starting from all the stakeholder here, everyone, that's the biggest concern in everyone's mind. So let's see how do we debate and bring up to a common, I think some kind of suggestion would be helping the industry, because I think directly or indirectly, everyone wants to promote the sector because it's a very novel sector and there's a lot of scope to promote. Thank you.
As we have already discussed, Pune. Hello, am I audible?
Yeah.
Okay. Pune has a biggest opportunity in terms of commercial and industrial clients. And it is also blessed with good amount of irradiations. And recently we have seen Maharashtra has come out with good solar policies. It has eliminated those 300 units which were not in favor of the rooftop business models, the investors. Barring that, they have a new concept of net billing has been introduced. Many good opportunities have been coming up. And recently in the discussion at the MEDA office, couple of weeks ahead, till date in Maharashtra, we have renewable energy policy, which covers all the renewable avenues. But now we'll be having a separate policy for solar, wind, repowering. Repowering is a great business in the recent time. We have a good windy sites, but because of the old turbines which are installed many years back, and most probably the PPAs of which are getting expired. So we have a good opportunity to capture those windy sites, but we need to have the policies in place. Recently, I think Mr. Talewar would be in a better position to tell us which new policies have been coming up to upbring the more solar revenues in the state. Recently, I have come up, state of Karnataka has come up with a solar policy that I found that was very interesting, as it was catering utility-centric. It has two models in it. That was utility-centric model, and other was third-party investment model, in which utility was a model. Utility can take a model where it can be like, it can act like an investor. It can act like a... You can take a rooftop rent with a PPA agreement, and there was a third-party investment model also in which the various subsidies like CSS and AS were introduced, which were earlier never with the rooftop models. So I would like you to throw some light on the...
Actually, Nandita rightly said, there is a huge market in Pune. Residential as well as the industrial and commercial for consumers. as far as our policies are concerned, basically MSEDCL works on annual revenue requirement, ARR. So we, first of all, I would like to say MSEDCL is pro-solar. They are not, we can say, we are not villain. We have to work for whole community. And as we are working on ARR basis, so we have to be tariff neutral. So the we have to take care of a consumer who are not utilizing solar or who are not installing solar. The burden of installation of the solar should not be on the consumers who cannot afford solar or not utilizing the solar installation. So that is the main thing. We are of the favor of that it should be win-win situation for all the stakeholders. So as far as recently there were MERC hearing has been conducted in all the divisional headquarters of in Maharashtra and many solar producers and stakeholders have raised their issues, and it is now the policy will be declared and the final decision will be taken after keeping the interest of all the stakeholder, and we still think that it should be always a win-win situation for all the stakeholders. So that is the main thing. Everyone knows it that the burden of higher slab benefit, which we have already considered in the tariff while planning the tariff, should not be burden to other consumer or other the stakeholder consumer. Already that this tariff of in industrial and consumers, they are saying that it is already on a higher side. As the we are giving the quality supply to all the consumers 24/7, of course the due to the reliability the tariff is there, because we have to purchase the power during the evening peak also. As per the solar limitations, we are already aware that there is limitation that we can generate only in daytime, and the banking benefit is given by us already. Net benefit is already there by DISCOM. Secondly, the existing consumers are nowhere affected. Up to 10 kilowatt, there is no burden on the household consumer and other consumers. So one should not fear that there will be solar will business will be adversely affected. Of course there will be a neutral, and our during this next tariff order, all these things will be covered in a balanced manner. Thank you.
Sir, I would like thank you for your views, but I stand to defer. I am a developer who is developing project under OPEX model. So as you said that the burden of the solar power should not come on the consumer, I totally agree with you. So under a OPEX model, I am offering to the consumer zero CAPEX, zero OPEX. I am building the plant with my own investment and bringing a power which is cheaper than the grid power. So I am actually doing a service to the customer that I am providing power which is cheaper than the grid power. At the same time, I am making returns on my investment also. So it's a win-win situation for both me and the consumer. But over here, India is a peculiar country where the consumer which is consuming more power is giving a higher rate of power rather than a consumer which is consuming less. So domestic consumers, we subsidize. So that is, I think, a policy at the national level that we are subsidizing consumer which are consuming less power by taxing industry and other commercial and industrial customers. So which is a policy at the national level. But I feel that as a nation, if we have to rise, and as a nation, if we have to be strong, we have to support the industry, because industry is the driving wheel of the nation. Economics is what drives each and every nation, and that's how the GDP of a nation is growing. So in order to do that, it is best that more better options of power should be given to the industrial client, and solar is bringing to the table. So our request is that you should allow industry to adopt solar. And the way to do it is, there are two models which are now working in Maharashtra, because as we know that open access model in Maharashtra is a no-go, because the surcharges and charges, almost more than 3.5 rupees surcharges, is making solar unviable. Even if I am, you know, offering a solar tariff of 4 rupees, with 3.5 rupees adding up, it is going more than the grid tariff, which the customer will not adopt. Customer will say, I would rather take electricity from MSEDCL. So what we are trying to say is that whatever surcharges and charges you are applying on open access, that should be, that some sort of weightage should be given to promote the industry. So the next model, which is now becoming popular in Maharashtra, is the group captive model, under which the customer is putting 26% of the equity into the model, and by doing so, it is becoming a co-generator. So by definition, since he is a co-generator, he gets all the benefits. So we feel that you should at least allow one model to let the customer decide. And I think if you allow the group captive model to be there, in which the consumer is ready to put some of his equity and become a co-generator, then it will be a win-win. The industry will also grow. The industrial client will also have an option to adopt solar. As well as, I don't have anything how your annual revenue model will work, but this is what we are at that crossroad, where as a government, as an industry, we have to decide how to move forward together.
I will just take one matter that as far as the cross subsidy surcharge is concerned, it is long pending issues, and all the industries are taking up this issue, but we all know that being the this due to the social obligation, we have cross subsidy to the consumers as per the policies of the government or the weaker section of the society. So to take care of that, the cross subsidy is there for even the industrial consumers are bearing that. So if we don't take that surcharge, of course that burden, just in my first quote, I told that this we are working on ARR model, annual revenue requirement model. So that burden will be passed on to some other consumer, and we cannot burden a particular category of consumer after a limit, because we can see if the tariff of the industrial consumer increases, of course that industries may migrate to some other states also. That will again create problems of unemployment and other issues also. So there should be a balance, just like just now I told that there should be tariff neutral policies. So all the stakeholders should be taken care of. As far as the cross subsidy surcharge is concerned, it is just to take care of the social obligation of all the sections of the society, but and that is to be that is decided after taking all the issues by our regulatory body.
Sorry, I'll just add one point. Sachin sir, as you told, we understand from your part your concern, and the only issue what we see is that the ecosystem that has to be built around, because last 10-12 years we are struggling to build up an ecosystem in which the EPC, the developers, either from IPPO, whatever is there, OPEX, CAPEX player. Of course, like you have your own issues, because without grid, we cannot keep on injecting the power. So anyhow, you are inevitable part of, we need a system. But the issue is that the outer envelope or the ecosystem that we are actually looking for, it keeps on changing constantly from state to state, from place to place. To be very frank, Thermax, when came into picture, we were the first company to do the net metering in Maharashtra. And of course, like we feel Maharashtra is one of the most progressive state in terms of adopting solar. And of course, like there is a 400 plus megawatt, as you told, the net metering has been done. So there is no doubt that DISCOM has done incredible job. But bringing all these policies whereby, like, for example, the recent judgment of MERC, when we talk the grid support charges kind of 4 rupees kind of thing, I think bringing itself the concept of 4 rupees would be defeating the entire purpose. You bring a policy in which 1.5 within 1 rupee, of course, like, I don't comment because it's a very, very technical job. I understand there are a lot of concerns from the DISCOM side. But please bring, I think the entire discussion should have come to a, I think, some kind of number, which would be really...
Exactly. I agree with your viewpoint.
No. Please, let me complete. It's not about the grid support charge. What I'm telling is that if at all there is a policy, it should be very, very justified if you bring at all. Of course, there is a lot of debate is going on why like that. I am not supporting as such, but I am talking on the concerns. Okay. No. Let's be logical. So that's the concern. So the entire ecosystem is getting disturbed. So I think that is what everyone is concerned for.
So if I can take that question, that as far as the grid support charges are concerned, what the grid is facing is that domestic or small consumers are injecting into the grid without having any responsibility of forecasting and scheduling. So the whatever number of units are going into the grid, they are coming as infirm power. So we can agree that to balance out the grid, the DISCOM can apply some charges, but it has to be very logical charge, because in this grid support, the inverter is only sensing the grid. It is neither taking any power, nor it is using any infrastructure of the grid. It is only sensing the power. And yes, to balance out the grid, if you have to do certain investment or you are putting some technology or some kind of infrastructure development we are doing to balance out the grid, we can agree. We can be part of that. We can even share some of that burden. But on a per unit basis, if you're going to charge in rupees, in fact, it should be in paisas. And that should not be even in per unit. It should be on a kilowatt capacity, because I don't know how many units I'm going to inject into the grid under net metering. Maybe 100% I will consume it, and only a few units only will go to the grid. So I think ideally it should be how many number of units I'm injecting into the grid. You only charge for that, and that too a very logical number, not an illogical number. Because I feel that if DISCOMs are not going to understand our plight or understand our pain, then we have no other option but to go to the courts of India and fight our cases. But we don't want to end up there. We have to coexist, we have to work together. Why go to that level? So we feel that whatever policies are formulated, it should be logical, it should be technical, it should be supported. We want to coexist, but at the same time, we want to grow this sector. This is good for the country as well as it is good for the environment. So that is our thoughts. Okay.